we need to support them. We need to help them. We need to get their lives back on track. And this is something that, you know, you learn a lot through this process. As brutal and as tough and as grinding as a campaign can be, it's tremendously mind expanding as well. And for my father coming to New Hampshire and speaking to so many parents who had lost children or sisters who had lost siblings or brothers, or it's changed his life in a very material way, and it makes it all the more real to him. And he, on a personal level, understands the pain having lost an older brother to alcohol abuse. So he understands the personal pain. But so many people have been so candid with him about their personal stories and their challenges that it's, I think, a big part of the reason why this is at the top of my father's list. He wants to take care of this so badly for the families that are struggling across this country, because it's just an enormous problem, and it's not getting better, it's getting materially worse. Like, where the trend is not in the right direction. So I would welcome and encourage everyone to go to his website and look at his speech. I believe it was October 15th, where he talks about the steps he would put in place to combat rampant drug, you know, how he would deal with the drug dealers, and how he would also deal with, as importantly, the treatment of those already addicted. And I think he has got some great policies. Governor Mike Pence was very influential in the crafting of this particular policy plan, and he has done a great job in the state of Indiana with the same issue. So they collaborated very closely on this, but it's so important. So, and I recognize here in New Hampshire, it's maybe the most important issue.
And I think that's something that I like about where he's headed and his thinking, is that we talk a lot about the treatment and recovery end of it, which is important, but we need to stop the flow of drugs into this country. We need to stop the drug dealers, and we need more prevention education so that we stop it on the front end.
And we need to control the pharmaceutical companies who are creating gateways for everyone, you know, who weren't looking to get hooked and who get hooked because of over-prescription and really just gross negligence on the part of doctors and pharmaceutical companies. It's devastating. So there needs to be a major focus, because the lines, the dots connect on this front, and a lot of it is starting with prescription painkiller abuse and then leading in the wrong direction thereafter.
You hold on a second. There are some questions that I've got that I need to get through first, okay? this one you talked about a little bit earlier, and it was a great answer, and you talked about your father's idea for child care. And I know I had some women sitting next to me saying, I'm voting for him. I love that answer. So can you talk a little bit about the child care deductions and his ideas on that end?
Sure, and I see a few kids with us today. There we go. This is an incredibly important issue on many fronts. First, most people don't realize, but child care is now the single largest household expense in over 50% of the homes in this country, even exceeding the cost of housing, which is incredible. So wages have stagnated, and the cost of childcare has gone through the roof. People are trying to deal with it, and oftentimes opting for far from ideal scenarios that aren't as safe as they would have otherwise desired, or having to leave the labor force completely because they can't bring or contribute a paycheck to their household income because the cost of childcare has become so enormous. You know, my father, one of the ways he's very unique is as a business owner, he's an employer of tens of thousands of people. At the Trump Organization, over 50% of them are women. And this isn't a woman's issue. You know, I actually don't even like talking about women's issues because I think all issues are women's issues. We don't talk about men's issues. So, you know, all issues are women's issues. But childcare is disproportionately affecting women. And we see it in their take-home pay. You see the fact that now married mothers make 81 cents on a man's dollar, whereas single women without children make 94 cents on the man's dollar. So motherhood is a greater predictor of wage inequality than even gender is. So this is something we have to solve for American families. Part of it starts with the tax code. We have an antiquated tax code that was created 65 years ago when women weren't a significant part of the labor force. Now we're 47% of that same labor force. So we have to account for the realities of so many dual income households. And he's proposed one prong of it is a tax credit for towards the cost of childcare in your state based on the average cost in your state. And it should be treated, it's a credit if you don't pay income taxes based on an expansion of the existing earned income tax credit program. And it's a deduction if you do pay taxes based on the average cost of childcare in your state. And I think this is so important because it's a cost of doing business. It's a work-related expense and should be treated accordingly. Similarly, though, the tax code should be neutral to stay-at-home parents. Because I know so many people, and it's deeply unfair that the tax code penalizes a stay-at-home mother or a stay-at-home father for the incredibly valuable work that they're doing in their homes and within their communities. So allowing the person who's doing the unpaid care to get that same credit towards their family's income, I think, is very innovative and incredibly important and necessary. Secondly, he's proposed the creation of dependent care savings accounts, which are similar to a healthcare savings accounts, which encourage people to save. You can contribute money to these accounts, pre-tax dollars, and it can roll over from year to year. And these can be used for after-school enrichment activities for children. They can be used to offset the cost of daycare, whether it's institutional or private, whatever the parent chooses, whatever the family thinks is right for them. Importantly, though, it can be also used for elderly dependents because women there are also disproportionately providing the unpaid care for elderly dependents as our parents' age and our grandparents' age and often leaving the workforce to take care of elderly dependents. So these healthcare savings accounts or these dependent care savings accounts can be used for adult daycare as well and to offset those costs. So I think these are all very important things. I welcome everyone to go check out the full plan because it's quite robust. But it's enormously important, and it's an issue that needs to be addressed.
Well, we're going to have to wrap up here. Ivanka's jetting off to someplace else. She's trying to hit as many places as possible. And I'm so grateful that she took the time to come here to New Hampshire to talk with us. It's very, very important. We're really excited about your dad. I'm going to ask you one other question, and then we're going to wrap it up and have you get out of here. What can we do? What can we do to help your father get elected next Tuesday?
Thank you. Well, that is a very important question. So Tuesday is literally around the corner. It's hard to believe that it's now upon us. And what you can do is, if you're inspired and if you want to be a force for change, first of all, get out and vote. Critical importance. But we'd also appreciate your volunteering over the next few days. And Mark, where's Mark? Mark is here. So if anyone is interested in volunteering, speaking to friends and neighbors, knocking on doors, making phone calls, any amount of time you're willing to give the campaign is so important. The momentum is on our side in Massachusetts and elsewhere around the country. But we want to bring it home on Tuesday. So we would very, very much appreciate it. And see Mark if you're interested in volunteering. Thank you all so much. I really, really appreciate it. And I will be back in New Hampshire tomorrow night with my father. Thank you.